So when you're here, and I need my youth leaders to help out, because you know how, oh no, you know what, come closer then. Come closer. You know how we do it. All right, so we're here to have a good time, am I right?
Yeah!
All right, that's what I'm talking about. Hello everyone, my name is Alicia Souter, and I'm the Executive Director of the Institute of Music for Children, and this is an incredible night for us, and it's been a long time coming. So I am gonna not talk too much, because we have a wonderful guest here. Assemblywoman Annette Quijano is here with us, and I just wanted her to say a few words, because she has been a supporter of the Institute. She has come to our event, she has donated, and she is here tonight. So thank you so much for being here. I'm so happy. Okay. I'm so happy to join everyone here today. This is a magical place. Once you go through the doors, you're going to see how magical it can be. If you haven't been here before, wait, you're in for a big surprise. I came a couple of times, and I cannot even in words tell you how transformational it is once you're here. When you see the children and young adults perform and then learn leadership. We need leadership today, don't you think?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's great when our children are learning it at such a young age. You know, being able to express yourself in words, music, is an important vehicle to have.
Absolutely.
And thank you for contributing. Thank you for donating. Thank you for volunteering. And you will see the magic later when you walk through the doors in the tours. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
And thank you for all you do for us and New Jersey, and for supporting youth. I am going to be talking a little bit later, and I'll tell you more about the Institute and some of the things that are happening. But first, we want to give you a taste of what it is we do. So we have designed some tours of various outdoor stations where we're going to have some performances, and some of our youth are going to be speaking about how this work and the work of the Institute has impacted them. So what's going to happen is we have three groups. We have the yellow group. Come on, come this way, walk this way. Like, woo, the yellow group. That's being led by Jocelyn. We have the blue group that's being led by Leslie, and she's in blue. So that was perfect. And then we have the red group led by Fritz. So I want you to look down at your tag, and you're gonna look and see what color dot do you have? And if you have a yellow dot, you're going to be the first ones to go on your tour, and you're going to follow Jocelyn, and you're going to go to two of the tours. They're going to be nice and short, and then you will be returning here for the reception and the ribbon cutting. All right, so all the yellows, you're going to join Jocelyn up here at the front.
Years. Today, I will be talking about creativity and why it matters. Creativity is so important because it's how we express ourselves. If there was no creativity in the world, everything would look the same. While creativity may mean bright paintings, it also means being brave and asking questions. Curiosity is vital in your creative process because without it, there would be no way to try your amazing ideas. Here at the Institute of Music, I have learned creativity brings out confidence. As a young person, when you are confident, you are less likely to be influenced by others. The Institute of Music has helped my creativity grow with their selection of classes, which has allowed me to recognize the uniqueness of my identity. It took me a while, but I was finally able to uncover the hidden parts of myself. This was beneficial to me because creativity can help draw out what is already there. Hidden talents and inner capabilities can emerge, which allows us to connect with our passions. Overall, creativity matters to me because it's how I portray myself and my ideas. Thank you.
Okay, great, 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 great. Now it's my turn to talk about creativity. I'm Jewelson. I think creativity
no,
is the best.
It's my turn. I'm Destiny, and I think the creativity...
Oh, this is very disrespectful. It is
no,
my turn.
It's
how
not your turn.
Dare
it's actually
you.
My turn.
Excuse
what
me.
No.
Thank you so much. It is my turn. Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome to the Creative Station. I am your host, Miss Elsie, and I'm approaching my sixth year teaching acting, singing, and dancing here at the Institute. And I have to tell you genuinely, I love working here. Trust me, they didn't pay me extra to say that, although they should. I genuinely love this job, not only because the Institute's incredible administration staff, who keeps this place going, was once a student who thoroughly enjoyed taking art, dance, singing, acting, and instrumental classes. As children, my sister and I were often the only black girls in our theater group. And while we did have some representation, most of our creative teachers were white. Being a black teacher amongst other black and brown teachers, while being led by a mostly black BIPOC administrative staff, which can I also just say are 75% women, allows me to be comfortable in my representation, and I introduce my students to black culture in all of its variety. Being able to teach a new generation of talent allows me to meld my work as an artist and the genuine love I have for children together. I purposefully create an environment where the students are able to freely express themselves and literally be as creative as possible. They inspire me to push limits in my own professional career. So my students are so creative.
How creative are they?
Y'all are creatives too, okay? You've been to the hospitality college, such as myself. So they are so creative that if I say they can act like a T-Rex, ooh, one T-Rex is wild.
One's a little stiff.
Freeze. Mom. But if there is, if I could also say to them that they get stuck in a snowstorm, it's a very violent snowstorm. Freeze. They're able to do it. And if I also say they get their feet stuck on a little bit of gum, they can show us.
Oh, that's nasty.
Freeze. And so, to further show our creativity, we actually prepared something very short for you. We're going to be reenacting one of our poems from a former student, Ashley McDowell, back in 2010. So places, everyone. Okay. And scene.
We were walking, talking, about nothing.
Not chilling.
Cause it's hot.
Like, red hot.
Down the block, cars going by, making noise. We had food in our bellies.
Hands, bags.
Laughing at anything.
Comments on everything.
Friends were made and none were lost.
Smiles with braces.
Wide eyes covered with glasses. Tall juniors and short freshmen.
A variety of friends.
All wanting the same dream.
Brought together on this very day, all accidentally heading down the same path.
Yet, bonded by this, red hot.
Not chilling.
We were walking, talking.
About nothing.
Fabulous. Give them another round of applause. That was so cute. And so now we're going to go on to our next tour. So thank you so much for coming to the creative set.
Wait.
Oh, yes. Gabriel, hi.
I have a speech.
Sweet baby, I don't know if you're on the program. If you,
it doesn't matter. Creativity is my jam.
I love jams. Okay, well, come on up.
Wait.
Christian,
me too.
Christian, you have a speech prepared?
No. Here's my speech.
All right, well, let's give it up for Christian and Gabriel.
Here we go, folks. What is creativity? Well, to sum it up, creativity is amazing.
Amazing!
Creativity is this magnificent thing that allows you to do anything you can imagine.
Anything!
Creativity is this thing that allows me to express myself and have fun in my life. The Institute has helped me find my inner creativity through many of its marvelous classes.
Like dancing, singing, drawing, cooking, hip-hop, anime. What? Fine. Buzzkill.
Through the Institute, I've learned to do things I didn't even think I could, such as acting, drawing, and playing all kinds of instruments, all of which have helped me mold into the person I am today.
Ooh, me too!
The Institute has inspired me to become a youth leader so I can spread my creativity to others. Everything the Institute has and does serves as a beacon of creativity for all kids.
Across the globe!
Thank you, everyone, for watching my show. He did none of the work. I did all of it. He just said it. Thank you. This is my show.
Thank you so much. And now, for real, this time you are able to go on to your next tour.
It was originally choreographed for a youth theater-led movie project called Broken Dancer, depicting a dance student in her final year of high school, dealing with the struggles of the pandemic, working on overcoming anxiety and allowing yourself to be given. Help is the premise of this piece.
Waiting in the silence, waiting for the sirens, signs, any signs of the light still. I don't wanna lose it, I'm not getting through this. Hey, should I pray, should I pray, yeah. To myself, to a God, to a Savior who can. Oh, pray the broken, oh, I said these broken words. Right open the whole place, pull me out of the dream. Oh, but the accidents, oh, I said the reactions are not ready to die, not yet. Underneath our bad blood, we've still got a sight, some home, still a home, still a home, yeah. It's not too late to build it back, cause a one in a million chance, still a chance, still a chance, and I would save those eyes.
short film featured at the 2020 Creative Youth Development Conference. The project was completely youth leader led, written, directed, filmed, edited, choreographed, marketed, and all the music was performed by our youth leaders between the ages of 14 and 23. Leadership is an important part of everyone's lives. At one point or another, someone has guided you in the right direction to get you where you are now. Everyone has had someone who acted as a role model for them. Here at the Institute, we strive to be those leaders that children need to grow into strong, intelligent, good people who will live fulfilling lives. I am only a recent addition to the Institute, and though my time during the summer was short, it was a valuable experience that I will cherish, and I look forward to experiencing more. Before joining the Institute, I danced at a studio. I had been dancing at a studio for my entire life, and though I learned a lot when it comes to dance, I cannot say the same for life experience. The environment was a competitive one, not one you'd expect to grow and thrive in. I may have just been in it to dance, but there were others who were only interested in winning awards. Dance is something I enjoy for the fun of it. It is a form of expression that I connect with well and enjoy doing. Dancing just to compete and show off has never been something I've been interested in. Trophies and medals pile up on my dresser, but hold no meaning in my heart. At the Institute, I've had teachers and mentors who have guided me through learning how to be a youth leader and given me reinforcement and criticism on how to improve. Dancing here is all for the fun and improvement. There is no competing against others and stressing about what judges will enjoy and what will get you higher points. The only people you have to impress are those whose opinions you care about. Here, it is more about the strength and technique you can show rather than how high you can get your leg. I know at the Institute I can find comfort in all the people here and can say they will be there for me when I need it. In just a couple months, I can confidently say that I see the Institute as a home and a family, one where everyone supports each other. I love dancing and working here and could never even consider going back to a studio. Not only do I believe I dance better here, I believe the Institute has even made me a better person.
Hello, my name is Vanessa Ferrara, and I am the host of your leadership station. I am currently the program associate here at the Institute, but I also am a parent and a community member. I have the privilege of being from Elizabeth and working at the Institute. It's easy to believe in the mission and our vision. It gives a better understanding of what it means to give back, why it's important to step up and be a leader in your own community. So when I think of leadership and what it means to me, a few things come to mind. First is confidence. You have to believe in yourself to step up to the plate and get the job done. Next is your team, believing in the people you work with and trusting their skills and judgment. Also learning their strengths and making them work for you. Last is taking risks, making mistakes and learning from them, inspiring your team by showing them you are vulnerable and not afraid to get your hands dirty. Leadership at the Institute of Music means helping a community grow. I get to bring people together to help create a nurturing and safe environment of art lovers in my hometown. And of course, what's most important to me is I get to raise my family in an environment where their creativity and growth is welcomed and encouraged, where they can learn to be responsible members of society that give back through a commitment and love of the arts. Thank you.
There are advertisers for you. Please help yourself to the advertisers. Please help yourself.
Hello everybody, my name is Chelsea Renee. I'm so happy to be here. I hope you are too. Enjoy the celebration. You've got the words to change a nation, but you're biting your tongue. You've spent a lifetime stuck in silence, afraid you'll say something wrong. Even no one ever hears it, how we gonna learn your song? So come on, come on, come on, come on. You've got a heart as loud as lions, so why let your voice be tamed? Baby, we're a little different, there's no need to be ashamed. You've got the light to fight the shadow, so stop hiding it away. Come on, come on. I wanna sing, I wanna shout, I wanna scream till the words dry out. So put it in all of the papers, I'm not afraid. They can read all about it, read all about it. Oh, at night we're waking up the neighbors while we sing away the blues, making sure that we're remembered, yeah, cause we all matter too. If the truth has been forbidden, then we're breaking all the rules. So come on, come on, come on, come on, just let the TV and the radio to play our tune again. It's about time we've got some airplay of our version of events. There's no need to be afraid, I will sing with you, my friend. Come on, come on. I wanna sing, I wanna shout, I wanna scream till the words dry out. So put it in all of the papers, I'm not afraid. They can read all about it, read all about it. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, we're all wonderful, wonderful people. So when did we all get so fearful? And now we're finally finding our voices. So take a chance, come help me sing this. Yeah, we're all wonderful, wonderful people. So when did we all get so fearful? And now we're finally finding our voices. So take a chance, come help me sing this. I wanna sing, I wanna shout, I wanna scream till the words dry out. So put it in all of the papers, I'm not afraid. They can read all about it, read all about it. Oh, 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 oh. My name is Chelsea Renee. I started going to the Institute when I was just 12 years old, and I recently graduated from the American Academy of Dramatic Arts, an acting conservatory in New York. Oh, thanks. Thank you. And now I am working to be a teacher in training here at the Institute, so life just comes full circle and stuff. So without further ado, I would love to introduce the Mayor of Elizabeth. Oh, Christian Bullridge. I was like, where are you at? Thank you.
Thank you very much, Chelsea. Let's give it up for Chelsea. What a great voice. What a great singer. Thank you very much, Chelsea, for that beautiful rendition. I also want to welcome the Lieutenant Governor who's here, Sheila Oliver. Thank you for coming to Elizabeth and Hillside. We truly appreciate it. And Alyssa, what a great job you've done. Thank you for everything here. I mean, you're absolutely terrific. And today we celebrate the Institute of Music, not only for the work they've done in the past, but being able to get these buildings and moving forward to the future. We have worked with the Institute through Community Development Block Grant through the years. I'm one of the fortunate people to hear Chelsea sing at a much younger age as she came up through this program. And all of you that are here supporting this program and supporting the arts are absolutely important to the success of communities. No community in our state or our nation can survive without the arts. And the Institute of Music has provided the arts for young people, not only in the city of Elizabeth and Hillside and Union and the surrounding communities, but throughout our state. I have to tell you, I've been coming here for about 10 or 12 years since they started. And if you hear the renditions of the young people when they sing and they perform poetry and they write and they form their own creativity, you would be extremely proud of 10 and 12 and 15-year-old kids about their ability and their creativity. But it couldn't happen without people like Alyssa and her staff and the teachers, people like Chelsea who stay in the program and then mature out and come back to teach. And they deserve a great round of applause for their commitment and their keep coming back. And whenever you get the Lieutenant Governor here in order to cut a ribbon, that's a big deal because she's really busy running for re-election. And yeah, I'm gonna say it, she can't. We need your support for her in November because we need people like Sheila Oliver to stay in office with Bill Murphy. And I wanna thank all of you for coming out, and once again, whatever you can do to help, whatever resources you can provide in order to keep programs like this going, this church, the Third Press as it was once called, is a historic church in our community. The First Press, which is on Broad Street in the city of Elizabeth, and the Second Press around the corner, if you ever get the chance, you can go through the cemetery where there are Revolutionary War graves there, and you can learn the history of the pastor of the First Press and how that pastor was influential during the Revolution by going to the prison ships on the bay at the foot of Elizabeth Avenue and tending to the prisoners before he was shot in the back, which galvanized this area on the Patriot cause in the 1700s. Just a little bit of a history lesson for those of you that may not know all that. There's a lot more. The Presbyterian Church in Elizabeth has been a founder of great religious activity, and today they pass on that religious activity to the arts, which we all need. Thank you for the presbytery. And I get to introduce Alyssa, the great Alyssa. I think it's her birthday. Is it your birthday today?
It just passed.
Can we all sing happy birthday?
Oh my God.
1, 2, 3. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Alyssa. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you so much, Mayor Bulwich. He has been a longtime supporter. He's here. We do a walk for the arts in the spring, and he comes and walks with us. So thank you for being our mayor, our leader, and for being such a huge supporter. And I'm going to bring up Gabby with me as we continue. And before we get started, I just want to recognize Mayor Bulwich, as well as Senator Joe Cryan, who joined us here today, as well as Assemblywoman Annette Quijano and Mayor Dalia Vertrees from Hillside. Thank you so much for being here, for supporting us, and for knowing how important the arts are for children.
Bienvenidos todos. My name is Gabriela Zambrano Ortegón, today's youth representative.
Y yo me llamo Alicia Sauter, y soy the Institute's executive director.
I have been a part of the Institute for over 6 years. Nine years. I've been a part of the Institute for 9 years. I began as a student, and then I trained to become a youth leader, and then I was promoted to a supervisor.
In addition to our year-round classes and lessons in the arts, our other central initiative is our Youth Leadership Program, which trains, mentors, and employs young change makers like Gabby.
And because of the leadership from Chris Torres and teaching skills I've developed, I became a teacher in training, and now I'm an official member of the teaching staff.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm also a junior.
Yes, we teach the arts, and we teach them well, but we also provide access so that no child is ever turned away because of a financial barrier. We are committed to youth development and strive to create an environment where students feel safe, are treated as individuals, are given healthy boundaries, and are asked to be responsible for the community they are a part of. And community is the other thing.
I got this part, Ms. Alicia. In order to talk about community, I'd like to first speak to culture, which is defined by region, artwork, tradition, and family. Most of our students represent the greater Elizabeth area, including Hillside, Linden, Union, Newark, and beyond. We embrace students and staff from various religious and ethnic backgrounds. I, like most of the students, am a child of immigrants. Therefore, I pride myself in appreciating the diversity of our community's ethnicities. Designing a culture of acceptance and empowerment is one of our core beliefs. You cannot have true community unless you foster this acceptance and empowerment.
We began over 25 years ago as a mission program of Third Westminster Presbyterian Church. And although our church officially and although the church officially closed its doors in 2017, their legacy and their commitment to the community lives on through us and through every child that has been impacted by our work. Can you just
Innovative Presbyterian leadership were committed to the future of the Institute and made it possible for us not only to remain here, but to become owners of this blessed property. And celebrating this tremendous acquisition and all the possibilities it brings is why we are all here today. I am so proud. Yes. I am so proud to call the Institute mine, because this environment is unlike any other, and it wasn't until I left the Institute that I realized all my superiors were women, and women of color, no less. Yes, it was normal for me to see minorities in positions of power and authority.
The Institute was founded by a black woman and is primarily governed, led, and is staffed by people of color, serving a community of people whose parents were born here in Elizabeth
and in Colombia, like mine, or Haiti, where Fritz's dad is from.
Well, Andrew's parents are from Cape Verde. Oh, and Alex's parents are from Nigeria, and Jocelyn's family and Julio's family are Ecuadorian, and Rachel's mom is Brazilian.
And we could go on and on and on. I grew up amongst this incredible culture of students, peers, artists, and leaders, and I always felt comfort. I felt I was being heard and welcomed. I never felt like an outsider. And growing up seeing people of color in power, naturally, I now imagine myself in those positions in the future. So what does our Institute future look like, you may ask? First, we imagine. Every artwork, musical piece, and composition begins within the imagination of an artist.
I, for one, imagine providing every child an equitable arts and cultural education, one in which where you live doesn't define the quality of the equipment, the facilities, the staff, or limit the programs available to you.
That's it. That's what we do here. But we need a bigger and better equipped space. We keep growing every year, and we need more space to effectively serve all of our kids.
Well, what would you see in this bigger space, Gabby?
So I literally want to see a gallery of the kids' artwork, where they can see their work displayed in an actual professional gallery like we see in universities. And they can think to themselves, I want to see my work on that wall. What do you imagine here, Miss Alicia?
Ooh, I want a performance space. I want a theater big enough for our shows so that we can fit all of our students on stage with lights and sound and dressing rooms, and then we could teach them how to build the sets and work the equipment and I'm getting excited.
Before you all arrived, we invited you to imagine with us. Now let's imagine together. What do you all imagine? What do you all imagine? So, come on, any ideas?
Help us build a vision.
Anything you want to see here at the Institute.
Gabby's gonna go out. What do we want to see here? Help us, everyone.
Yes, back there.
Go, go, go.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm almost there.
A dance studio. I would love a dance studio.
What do you want to see?
Probably a set of musical and beautiful stuff.
Yes, yes, sir.
Oh, there's one back there.
I've had the pleasure to see numerous performances, so I'd like to see a theater.
Ooh, yes. Thank you, Julie. Yes, we do.
And oh, another one.
All right, we only have time for one more.
An actual studio.
Oh, well, two more. And what kind?
A music studio.
Ooh, a music, like where we could record? That's a good one. A recording studio. I like that. Right here, and that'll be the last one.
I don't know how you do it, but I want you to take the kids to outer space.
We could paint that. We could do that.
We can figure that out. And I hope that this is just inspiring you to have more ideas, because we have a board back there that we would like you to contribute. You can write on your ideas so that we can start to make those ideas a reality.
So you've all done a fantastic job, and I believe we can make this happen. Together, it's the Institute way. George Bernard Shaw said it well. You will what you imagine, and at last you create what you will.
And you can start that tonight by making a donation to contribute to our mural project so that we can transform the face of our main building from that of what was once only a church to now will become or is a vibrant arts, education, and cultural center. Our goal for tonight is to raise another $30,000 to begin this mural project. Join us and take this first step towards making our imagination a reality.
Thank you. Now, while we can sit here and imagine all night, and once again, you can write your imaginations on the board, let me introduce a fervent supporter of our work, the Honorable Union County Commissioner, Dr. Angela Gerritsen. Now, Dr. Gerritsen of Hillside has over 16 years of government experience as a school board member, councilwoman at large, mayor, and now as a Union County Commissioner. She is the lead on the Union County League of Municipalities and the Union County Black Leadership Caucus, and as the New Jersey Association of Counties delegate. As the Chief External Affairs Officer in the Office of the President of the New Jersey Institute of Technology, Angela Gerritsen has been recognized for her impact on college and career pipelines, engaging the school with secondary and post-secondary institutions, the workplace, and the community. She began her career at Rutgers University, New Brunswick, Eagleton Institute of Politics, Commissioner Gerritsen earned a bachelor's from Syracuse University and a master's in public administration with honors from Rutgers, and she's a member of the Alpha Kappa Alpha sorority. Please give a hand.
And she didn't say that she's from Hillside, too, did she? Woo! Good evening, everyone. To all the elected officials, to my eloquent and elegant sorors of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated who are here tonight volunteering for this amazing organization, to all the Divine Nine, and especially to my chapter, Omega Psi Omega Chapter, accept my sincere thanks for all who's in presence and who's committed to this important event tonight. Our community is strengthened by all of our collective efforts. I am Angela Gerritsen, and I greet you today as a member of the Union County Board of Commissioners. As I was introduced, I am very, very proud to share that what makes this particular event so important to me is that I was a violinist as a child, and I also played the flute. So I understood the power of music. As children understand the power of music, it is from the rhythm of our beating hearts to the lifting of our voices in song. But music is the movement of our bodies, the expression of our minds, and the force of the human spirit. All of the heartfelt music can be experienced at this institute, and it is encouraging to witness a new cycle of learning and growing as new generations of creators are going to be inspired right here. Give this organization a round of applause. We all know too well that the arts are constantly under assault and in need of supportive voices and actions. Thanks to the tireless resiliency and the forcefulness of so many amazing people here today, the arts will thrive with the next generation. But we are proud, proud, proud to be able to salute the work that we saw tonight from the young people and all of these dedicated folks who've been here. So as we now turn to the keynote speaker who has been a worthy advocate of the arts and culture for our young people, our Lieutenant Governor Sheila White Oliver. She started out in arts and cultural organizations, the Leaguers exactly, in Newark. And from there, she directed the minds and talents of scores of young people who have returned as public officials, arts advocates, educators, and policymakers to serve the community. She has been particularly important as a role model for young women of color and women seeking to name their own tunes for their own destinies. Lieutenant Governor Oliver has set the bar sky high, and she has worked all her life to help others reach that bar. Coming up through Newark Public School Systems, Sheila Oliver graduated from the historic Lincoln University, an alma mater of 2020 from NJIT where I work. She is Dr. Lieutenant Sheila Oliver. On this impressive road that our Lieutenant Governor has traveled, she is not only the first woman of color to win a statewide office in New Jersey, she has also served as a county legislator and was on the front line to support when we changed the historic name to county commissioners from freeholders. And she then was in the General Assembly where she became the first African-American woman in the history of our state to serve as the Assembly Speaker in 2010. Throughout her life, Dr. Sheila Oliver has exemplified and amplified the power of education. Along the way, she has inspired a whole generation of women to aim for the growth and change that serve to pierce glass ceilings. I am proud to be one of those women. And so tonight, ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pride that I introduce New Jersey Lieutenant Governor Dr. Sheila Oliver.
Good evening, everyone. I am so enthralled and impressed by the Institute of Music for Children. I didn't even know that this organization existed. And you are indeed the best kept secret in the state of New Jersey. There's no doubt about it. You are the best kept secret. When I arrived, Betty greeted me, and she was sharing with me the long, arduous road that the Institute has been on. And as I listened to Mayor Bolwich describe the history of the Presbyterian Church in Union County, I was very impressed with that as well. I am a history lover, and I am just so touched that the Presbyterian Church saw fit to work with the Institute to transfer ownership of this property for a cause such as promotion of the arts. Now, I'll tell you a little secret. Angela shared with you some of the things that have happened along my life's journey, but I am a repressed artist. I really, really am. No doubt about it. And I would say to my colleagues that I served within the legislature, I don't know how I ended up doing what we do. That was not in my game plan. If you get my high school yearbook and you look under my photo about what's your aspiration, my aspiration was to go in some associated arts field, but I got deterred along the way. Like Angela, I had the opportunity as a youngster to take music lessons. And I too, Angela, played the violin. Now, it didn't lead me to Carnegie Hall or any place like that, but the experience of, and the pride of carrying my violin case to school and to lessons, it just really elevated my self-confidence and the aspirations I had for myself. That is what the arts does for young people. I had a little stint as a piano player, and wasn't Carnegie Hall level though. But it taught me a lot of things. We were all disappointed when through the years, because of, you know, tough budgets in school districts, and school districts had to begin to prioritize what they could keep and what they cut out. And in a lot of school districts across the state, arts and arts education was one of the earliest things to go. I think that was a terrible mistake, because students who have the opportunity to pursue the arts, it really creates students who are academic achievers. There is a connection between arts education and academic achievement. There is a connection. And, you know, I served a stint on the school board in the city of East Orange. I served as the president for a while. And it was during a period of time when we were creating a magnet school system in East Orange. And a lot of people during that period of time questioned, is this idea going to work? Well, it worked. And close to 30 years later, 20 some odd years later, the most successful schools in that magnet school system are the Cecily Tyson School of the Performing Arts, the Langston Hughes School, and the school that does have a curriculum that focuses on filmmaking. Also, literature. Yeah, it worked. And literature is another aspect of the arts. And when we look at those that are the lyricists who write music and, you know, just have that creativity to create words to accompany that music,
the speakers before me said something that is very profound. The arts can change your life. The arts are transformative. I don't know about you, but I love to visit museums. And as a youngster growing up in Newark, when you could ride the bus for 15 cents. On Saturdays, my mother and father would give me a couple of dollars, and I would take the bus down to Washington Street in Newark. My first stop would be the main branch of the Newark Public Library, where I would roam the stacks and read whatever I wanted to read and go up and down. My second stop would be next door at the Newark Museum. This is as a youngster. At the age of 14, 13, here I am having the opportunity to wander through the galleries, to attend the planetarium programs, and to learn something about the creation of arts, visual arts and, you know, performing arts and everything that everyone described. Having that experience makes you sensitized to humanity and the human condition. That is what we are lacking in our communities today. The sensitivity to empathize and relate to the human condition. A painting can do that for you. Standing and gazing at a painting. Music certainly can move you because it sets the imagination in motion. Literature can do that. I encourage young people all the time. I know you've got your tablets and your cell phones and all of that technology. Just try once picking up and having the feeling of a book in your hand. You can get engrossed and lose yourself in the words that have been put to paper by those that create literature. The arts, I believe, speak a universal language. And as Alyssa began to describe the various students that are participants in the programs of the Institute, just listen to where they came from. Nigeria, Colombia, Brazil, right here in the good old New Jersey, United States, students from here. Students from all around the world can communicate with one another and socially and culturally relate to each other because they have a shared arts experience. Last week or so, maybe 2 weeks ago, and Dr. Garrettson was there, the Newark Symphony Hall is undergoing a capital campaign to restore the Symphony Hall to its former position of grandeur in this area. Yeah. And next to Symphony Hall is something that was once known as the Terrace Ballroom. The Terrace Ballroom is also undergoing a transformation and will be known as the Dionne Warwick Institute. And Dionne Warwick is very involved and engaged. But when Mrs. Tina Knowles Lawson, Beyonce's mom, came to an afternoon tea 2 weeks ago, it was an interactive kind of an experience. Mickey Taylor, who once was the editor of Essence, who grew up in Newark, her mom worked for Sarah Vaughan. She was the interviewer, and she interviewed Mrs. Knowles about the experience of raising two daughters who are who they are today because she said in her neighborhood in Texas, there was a community arts program. Beyonce and Solange started going to that program when they were 3 and 4 and 5 years old. It's in the programs and plays that were put together. She knows because of her own daughter's experience what exposure to the arts can do. So she and her husband have created a program in Los Angeles that's known as Waco. When I first heard about it, I thought it was Waco, Texas, because the family's from Texas. But it's not. Waco stands for where arts are created. That's what Waco stands for. So they have a center in LA. It is sort of like the Institute of Music for Children. And they have committed to forming a partnership with Newark Symphony Hall, which will bring the experiences of LA artists, have collaboration with artists here in New Jersey. At that afternoon tea, there were two performers. And I don't know if Equa Colson, who taught the arts in the East Orange School District for years, might know who I am speaking of, but there was a young woman who was playing the flute, and she was playing back and forth with a young man who she was doing the violin, and a young man was doing the flute. I thought all while I was at that event that these were two professional musicians. They were a young man who lives in Bergen County and the young woman who lives in the city of East Orange. Performance level musicians and young people. That is what the Institute of Music for Children can produce right here, the place we are all standing and sitting at tonight. You can be inspired by the facility itself and the historic nature of these buildings. When I sat down and I looked up and I saw this canopy of trees, mature trees, and the vegetation, and I thought about creation of gardens and all kinds of even architectural experiences. This institute will thrive. You've lasted for a quarter of a century, 25 years, and yeah, you can give a hand clap to that. Because I know it isn't easy to raise money to keep things like this going in a community. But there are arts lovers all across the state of New Jersey and outside of the corridors of New Jersey. You know, one of the earliest things that Governor Murphy did when he assumed office was to restore funding for the arts in our public schools in New Jersey. One of the earliest things that he did. And I just get thrilled by the work of the New Jersey Council of the Arts. I am thrilled by the work that our Secretary of State does because she's got a lot of arts initiatives in her portfolio. And I just want everyone here at the Institute to understand, just like I said, I was amazed at this place. The more we can expose other New Jerseyans to the Institute of Music for Children right here on Salem Road in Elizabeth, I know that you will not have to fret going forward about having a solid financial foundation so that you will be here in another 25 years. Woo! It is possible. It is possible. Years ago, we had the Newark School of the Performing Arts that was started by two teachers, by the way, that I had when I was a student at Weequahic High School. And Stella Lass was a music instructor. Yeah, somebody knows of Stella. And when she left teaching, she got with folks and they started the Newark School of the Performing Arts. In its early days, they were known all around the country for a Suzuki violin program that they started. These little 3, 4, and 5 years olds in classrooms with Suzukis, and putting on the concerts was just exceptional. Tisha Campbell, an actress who some of you may know, who starred in Martin, she was a student from Newark School of the Performing Arts, as was Faith Evans. Now, the young people will know Faith because she married Biggie Smalls, but Faith is an accomplished vocalist as well. New Jersey is a hotbed of artistic talent, and it's time that we step out and show the world what we've got. All of that can be born right here on the premises of the Institute. It can be born right here. We have to begin to not think we're this little state of 9 million people. There's something that I cite all the time. Someone told me that Ben Franklin wrote it, but I never looked it up. But there is a saying that New Jersey is a valley of humility nestled between two egotistical giants, Philadelphia and New York.
Yes.
We can compete with New York. We can compete with Philadelphia. The level of artistic performance that those two cities offer, we can offer that right here in our valley of humility. But we're not humble anymore. We know who we are. We know what we have. We know the talent of our young people. In this state, let's stand up, support them, support institutions like the Institute, and let's have future stories for New Jersey of young artists who take to the world and national stage. Thank you.
Thank you so, so much for that incredible and inspirational speech. And I was hoping that you wouldn't go quite yet because we wanted to do our ribbon cutting. And I was hoping that you might cut the ribbon and do that honor for us. Yes? Wonderful. So we get to keep her here, and we would love to bring back Commissioner Garrettson, who was also amazing, and Mayor Bolwidge, and our students. And before we do that ribbon cutting, we would love to bring up Reverend Christopher Belden, who was the pastor in charge of the administrative commission prior of Third Westminster Church. Come on up, Reverend Belden.
I'd also like to bring up Betty Prezi Bryant, who's my colleague, and I'm very proud to say my friend. This is what an angel looks like. please let us join our hearts together in prayer. Almighty God, you are the creator of all good things. We know you as the Ancient of Days, the creator of time. So today we bow before you, giving thanks for the gifts of the past, the present, and the future. We give thanks for yesterday. Thanks for those who worshiped in this place and served you as this changed from wilderness to farmland, to town, and finally to city. We give thanks for those men and women who built churches and schools and proclaimed your mercies and taught your blessings. We give thanks for those who lifted praise in song and service. Ever-present Lord, we give thanks for today. We give thanks as the praise and the ministries that happened in this place now develop further in service of your children. We give thanks that youth are being introduced to the blessings of the arts that you have given the world, the music, the dance, the colors, the speech. Oh Lord, so much that you have given us. And we give thanks that these young people are being encouraged to see that they also are the very best of what you wanted for this world. We give thanks that for those who have shown your love by their gifts, their time, their talents, and their love. And God of the future, we give thanks for tomorrow. We thank you for blessings of new possibilities and new growth and new life happening in this place. We give thanks, and now we lay claim to your promise that you will be with us always. We pray that your spirit will abide here to bless all those who teach, those who administer, those who clean and prepare, those who do all those millions of things necessary to create space in which creativity and imagination and growth can happen. We pray that your spirit will abide you with thanksgiving and with the prayer that you will bless what we have done, that you will multiply what we are doing now, and that you will allow the abundance of your grace to shower upon your children now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
I think we're ready.
We'll do a count of three. One, two, and three. Woo!
I can't have imagined a more beautiful evening. I want to thank everyone for being here tonight to celebrate, but it's not over, so don't go anywhere, because now the party can begin. And again, thank you so much to Lieutenant Governor Oliver for being here, for her incredibly inspiring words, to Commissioner Garrettson, to Mayor Bulwidge, and to so many others who are here to support us, to the Mayor of Union, Michelle Dellisforth, to the Elizabeth Board of Ed President, Jerry Jacobs, and the Board of Ed Commissioner, Stan Neron, Union County Deputy Manager, Amy Wagner, Director of Human Services, Debbie Ann Anderson, and to our Omega Psi Omega Chapter, AKA Sorors, who are here volunteering, and the president, Latricia Garland. We thank you so much. And there's so many other people that I'm going to thank and want to thank. And to all my students who came here and performed and practiced, and my youth leaders that are working this, and all of my incredible staff, and all of that have worked so hard to make this happen, and all of my teachers who jumped in and threw in cameras and all sorts of things and speakers at the last minute to make this happen. This is a true community, and you, all of you here, are part of it. Please share in it. Please talk to each other. You have to meet at least three people you didn't know.